Welcome to the newest episode in an ongoing Legendarium series about the plagues that have struck and shaped humanity. In this installment, the Cyprian Plague of 250 AD, we will talk about the end of the Roman climate optimum and how it opened the door to the crisis of the 3rd century. During this tumultuous time, the Cyprian Plague swept into the Roman Empire. The Romans were lucky to have built their empire during a time of warm, wet, and stable weather across the Mediterranean. The so-called Roman climate optimum ensured bountiful harvests year after year and a strong economy through the year 150 AD. After that time, the climate grew less reliable, droughts and severe cold spells became more common, and far worse, the critical Nile floods became erratic, which threatened the harvests in Egypt, breadbasket to the Roman Empire. Then in the 160s, the Antonine Plague swept into the famine-stricken Roman Empire and killed 7% of its population. To see my video on the Antonine Plague, please follow the link in the description. For a time, the empire rebounded under an African Syrian dynasty called the Severans. But in the 240s, a disastrous drought struck the empire during a time called the Crisis of the 3rd century. Seeing a chance, Germans on the Danube and Parthians in the east pushed into Rome's borders in search of loot. For a time, the emperors held them off, at least until the plague of Cyprian erupted in Ethiopia around the year 250 AD. It spread north along the Red Sea trade routes that connected Ethiopia to Rome. The plague struck a population already weakened by food shortages. It would be named after a bishop in Carthage named Cyprian, who wrote an account of the plague. He described patients suffering from bouts of diarrhea, continuous vomiting, and swollen throats. As the disease advanced, their eyes filled with blood and stained their teeth. Most of the patients died within days. Both pagans and Christians saw the plague as divine punishment upon a sinful humanity. Modern scholars have made a number of suggestions about what the plague might have been, including bubonic plague, typhus, smallpox, and anthrax. Most likely, it was a viral hemorrhagic fever similar to Ebola. Based on surviving accounts, it was highly contagious and could be spread by contact, even by touching another person's clothes. To stop it, the Romans abandoned traditional funerary practices and resorted to simply hurling the dead into ditches and covering them with lime. In some cases, they burnt them in massive pyres. Cyprian's biographer, a stern moralist, wrote with horror about the social breakdown he witnessed during the plague. People abandoned dying family members for fear of catching the dread illness. As people fled the plague-stricken cities, bloated corpses were left to rot in houses and on the streets. Christian bishops, however, urged their followers to bury the dead and minister to the sick, whether pagan or Christian. The Emperor Decius, himself a fervent pagan, had other ideas. He ordered all the citizens of his empire to sacrifice to the gods in the hopes of relieving the plague. In fact, he ordered every citizen to also get a certificate that they had sacrificed. While some Christians were not above bribing a public official to get a certificate of sacrifice, some Christians simply refused to sacrifice at all, and this triggered the first empire-wide persecution of the Christians in the history of Rome. Nonetheless, the Christian church would survive in large part because it won many admirers for its willingness to bury the dead and tend to the sick. On the other hand, the empire would be changed forever. With so many men dead, it became more hard-pressed than ever to fill the ranks of the legions. And especially in the West, many people left the cities for the countryside and didn't come back, which had a significant impact on Rome's economy, which was based on international trade. That wraps things up for this episode of The Legendarium. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, press like. If you want to see more, press subscribe. And if you've got anything to say, let me know in the comment section. Thanks again for joining me, and I hope that you have a great rest of the day.